I'm very happy to be in a place where animation and VFX education has been taken in the right sense. I'm also extremely happy to be invited as a chief guest in an event where we are honoring these legends, you know. So these guys, you know, I know each and every one of them very personally. They have dedicated their life towards the animation industry. Today, industry is quite large, and I think the entire you know, community, people like us, and you know, the future generation, they are indebted to these guys in a very, very big way. So I don't think we are honoring them, we are being honored by inviting them. So thank you very much, guys. I'm so pleased to be here. I'm not going to have a long speech, but let me just tell you a few words. I come from a finance background. I'm a chartered accountant by profession. I got into this business very accidentally. You know, I have been asked to be the CFO of this business from day one. And later, 2-3 years later, the investors, the family basically wanted me to take over the business. And then I was forced to get into the business of animation. This was several years back. So I am probably the only person who doesn't have an arts or animation background in the thing. So whatever I'm saying, probably from a slightly different point of view. When we started the business 21 years ago in 1999, the animation industry was in very nascent stages. And I've seen actually some of these guys have started, but I'm sure that they also agree with me. This was at the very, very early days of the industry in India. One of the biggest problems we encountered, because we have, our mandate was actually to build an animation studio of scale and size, not a small, because it was funded by global investors. So the mandate given to us was, you build a studio, an international studio of size and scale. First and foremost is manpower, right? You need to have people. This business is all about people business. So how do you develop people? And at that particular point in time, we tried to get all the people, a lot of people from Maharashtra, a lot of people from Bengal, a lot of people from Kerala, all over the country we bought it. In a very short span of time, we realized that, and luckily we got a client, an international client, Cartoon Network has given us a good amount of work as well. So in a very envious position, you started the studio, your international client and your international work. But very short period of time, we realized that we will not be able to execute it because the skill set is not there in the people. So at that point in time, we had to bring in around, I don't know, the people who came to our studio at that point in time. You have seen a large, you know, people from Philippines, Korea, Australia, and from other countries. We had around 75 people from other countries in the studio, just to make sure that, you know, our local artists are given international exposure. Reflecting back today, I think probably that is the best decision we have ever taken in terms of instilling skill set. We have no problem, we have no depth of raw talent in the country. Absolutely no depth. You know, I mean, our artists fundamentally, and the talent is at par with anywhere in the world. What we really lacking is the skilling. The art and technology of animation, the skilling, instead of skilling, I think that is where I think we have a problem. And the scenario today is very different, vastly different 20 years back, right? When at that particular point in time, we had not people, we had no domestic industry, not even a single television network was running domestic cartoons. You know, all that setup, situation has drastically changed today. Today we have 14 national channels competing against each other, doing you know, domestic content. The VFX industry is in a exponential growth. This is an industry in the last 4-5 years has been growing at the rate of 15 to 20%. where our GDP growth is only 4 or 5 or 6%. So this industry is growing 3 times the growth of GDP growth. So you guys are very lucky because you are going to be part of a, you know, kind of a growing thing. However, I think the fundamental problem which we encountered at the beginning, the supply and demand gap, right, in terms of skill set, I think unfortunately it still exists. Still, we have a lot of work coming from both India and from outside. When we started executing this, we basically started recruiting people from, youngsters. Then suddenly we realized that, you know, they had not been skill problem, train problem. So that particular problem is still there. And what is the use of today in animation? It is not just in the entertainment sector. It is used in almost every walk of life. You know that TV series and theatrical feature film use animation in a significant way. We have seen it in India. It is after the OTT platform invention, I think the requirement of the appetite for content has grown multifold. So there is no depth of work there. Even mainstream sectors like medical, engineering, medical animation, architecture and visualization. Friend like Suresh has been working in advertisement for a long period of time. In education, you really look at Baiju's and all that, 75% of the work is animation, right? Defense, huge, I actually very recently met a company in the defense side using animation, which is a $1 billion company in London. I never thought that, that kind of company existed in the world and they're using animation. So every walk of life, teaching, learning, every walk of life, fortunately, this art form is being used. So the future, I believe, this is very, very important for the students like you. In another 3-4 years, you are going to be part of this industry. I think, in my opinion, the future actually is very good. There is definitely a lot of naysayers that many times I have heard that, this industry doesn't have future, it's a problem. If you are really confident about your capability, I really don't think there is really a problem. I'm a very, very big believer of this industry. I can tell you, from the last 20 years history, when I started this business, there was, as I told you, the domestic, there was not even a single animated show in the television. Look at what it is. Where we are today, right? When we started the business, I used to get around $100,000 per episode from US. Today, that number reduced to 30,000. I used to get 3,000 from India, and today it is, we are getting $50,000. So you have really seen the change in the shifting, kind of paradigm of India. Not only just India, a lot of these developing economies, India, Indonesia, China, 2 years back, China was not 2-3 years back, China was not in the picture. Today, in our business, for Toonz, China is the country, second largest country which contributes the most money, revenue. So, countries like India, China, Indonesia, Arab countries, Africa, these are all emerging. So, I really don't think maybe the work will reduce from the US, the work may reduce from Japan, because most of these countries, in terms of population growth, They have a negative growth. In Europe, population is growing negatively. So the kids population is coming, less and less. In 10 years time, the kids population will shrink 40%. So there can be a negativity there. But there is, there are places like India, Indonesia, China, Arab countries, Hispanic countries, Latin. So all these countries, I really think if you really look at next 10 years, that is what it matters to most of you. I think the growth is here. Okay, so that is the reason why I believe there is an opportunity there. To my, end friends, 2 absolutes in our business is quality and on-time delivery, right? You need to deliver quality work and you need to deliver on-time. And my friends who are getting awards today will tell that this is not a 10-to-5 job, unfortunately, right? Because whether broadcasters or theater owners, they basically actually fix a launch date. whether it is theatrically or a TV, probably 1 year in advance, and then we'll give you the work. So unfortunately, there is no way you will be able to change those things. So I know that at times people stay in the studio for 3 days continuously. Right? This all comes only from passion. Right? You cannot, you know, I mean, work on 3 days, 4 days continuously, either because of passion or because of fear. Right? Fear doesn't work, right? On the long term. Fear doesn't work in the long term. It may work for a short while. And especially don't work in the current generation. My father's generation, it may work. The Industrial Revolution time, because, you know, there was no opportunity. And the fundamental thing is, you know, I need to get food. I need to get very basic fundamentals. So even if your employer abuses you, you stick with them. Loyalty was there. Then come the IT revolution. The sustainability is there. They were looking at quality of life. Right? Standard of life. Not quality of life. Standard of life. Today it is all gone. Information revolution is also gone. Today it is digital revolution, social media revolution. Information is all there in the computer. You can go and check it. You don't need information revolution is not there. Today is a social revolution. In this particular area, you definitely need to get quality of life. You need to provide a good environment. You need to provide good opportunity for them to grow. You need to be recognized. So it's a very different kind of people we are talking about. So you definitely need to be very passionate about it. You also need to view it very differently. There is actually a story when a lady was walking down the street of Rome. She has seen a guy who is breaking rocks, right? So she asked the person, "What are you doing?" He said, "You don't see me what I'm doing? I'm breaking stones, right?" And he was very unhappy because it was a very sunny day. And she has walked a little past down the lane, and she saw another person who is really doing it, with a smile on his face. She asked him again, "What are you doing?" So the answer was very different. The answer was, "You know what I'm doing? I'm actually helping to build the tallest cathedral in the world." Right? Two people are doing the same job. One guy perceiving this as a mere stone breaking. The other guy perceiving this as a larger purpose. He is thinking that I'm helping to build the tallest cathedral in the world. Think about that, the pride, the, you know, kind of the energy, the passion in him. That's what it is about passion. I would say all the youngsters need to have a PhD. It's not the doctrine which I'm talking about. I'm talking about passion, hunger and discipline. Right? Passion, you need also the hunger. You need to have the intensity in you to learn new things. Today the world is changing every day. Even in our this thing, have you ever thought that we can do binge watching? Right? It's changing every day. Technology is changing every day. What you are learning today, I can tell you that by the time you get out of this school and then started work, whatever you have studied will change. The technology is changing every day. So you need to continuously learn. What I learned 30 years back in my school, no use today. Right? You need to learn. You need to have the mentality to learn. You need to really, really learn. And you need to have the hunger to learn. Then it is discipline. Nothing will happen in one day. These guys will tell. 20, 25, 30 years of hard work, it will take where it used to be. So you need to have that discipline. Right? You do everyday exercise. Everybody will say exercise. Every day you do exercise and go and look at the mirror. You're not going to see any change on a daily basis. But after 6 months, when you look at it, you will be able to see the change, right? So that really needs discipline. Okay? So if you have these kind of qualities, and two other qualities also I will tell, I think very, very important. One is collaboration. Because this business is all about collaboration. We will get a series or a film. So a series on a film which is 400 or 500 scenes, each scenes are done by different people. If people don't collaborate, if don't work in a team, right, you will never be able to get continuity, right? So this is a collaborative effort. It is also about communication. Because most of the time, you need to really understand what the director tells, right? So you need to have a definitely communicative to each other. So these are the kind of qualities which, you know, we would look as a, you know, an animator, as, you know, when we recruit people, these are the kind of qualities we would look at. We are running short of time, so I will definitely stop. I wish all of you students an amazing career in VFX and animation sector. And thank you very much, guys. Your presence really made me very happy.